me something I won't forget. All I want is an adventure, full of dreams in my head. Cause I'm tired of pretending. Give me something I won't forget. And today I'm doing a super, super exciting video. This is my first DIY video I've ever done. Actually, I wouldn't say ever, probably the second one I've ever done, which is kind of embarrassing. Today I'm doing a DIY collab with Tana Montana, and I just freaking love her name. It's the cutest thing. So yeah, we are doing a DIY collab together, so make sure you go check out her video, and that'll be down in the description box. But yeah, today I'm doing DIY summer room decor, and I'm showing you 5 different things you can do for your room, and I just love all of these. I don't honestly watch a lot of other DIY videos, so if you think that I copied someone else, I promise you I did not try to at all. I really don't watch a lot of DIY videos because I just never do them. I hope you guys like this video, and if you do, make sure to give a thumbs up. And also, if you recreate any of these things that I showed you today, make sure to send me a picture of all my social media. That is Janine Amapola. Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all of that is Janine Amapola. So I hope you guys like this video. I hope it is fun and you guys get some entertainment and you got to learn how to do some cool DIYs for your room. So let's get right into this video. Okay guys, so for the first one, you're gonna need a jar, some sand, and fake flowers. I got all of these from Michael's Craft Store. The first thing you're gonna do is get out your sand, pour that into the jar. We're smashing mics in karaoke bar. Now go ahead and pick out your fake flowers and decide which ones you would like to stick in the jar. And these do have wire in them, so they're a little bit harder to cut, so I had to bend it in half and then cut it. Just kind of pick out the flowers you want, arrange it how you want it, and then you will stick it in the jar. I love this feeling. I also did kind of bend them a little bit so that they would stay properly, and yeah, that's all I did so far for the flowers. So that is how it looks with just the flowers, and then I went ahead and grabbed some twine, and I wrapped it around my jar 4 times, and at the end I added a bow just to give it more of a cute summer vibe, and I think the twine and the sand combined just looks super summery. I just love this DIY, and I hope you guys like it too. Sometimes these memories pull us under. Okay, so it's time for my favorite DIY in this whole video. So first I went on Tumblr and searched summer, and I found lots of summer pictures. I printed them out and printed out 32 of these, and you will need to cut these up in the size 4x4. So I used this one as a reference. This is an Instagram photo, and I basically use this as a guide to cut all the rest. So as you can see here, I just kind of framed it what I wanted in the actual picture. I measured it up, used it against the other one, and cut it. And you will see that it is also going to be 4 inches tall then. Now I went ahead and cut off the white sides of the other one so they were both the same size. And we want all of them in this shape, so I went ahead and cut them all in this shape. Okay, so now I added some tape on all of the photos, and I made them into a circle to where you could tape it on the wall as well as the picture and make it stick. And this is what it's going to look like after it's done, so you guys can see and use it as a reference to know where to place the photos. You guys can go ahead and screenshot that or something if you're planning on doing this. But yeah, I went ahead and taped them on the wall, and this is my favorite DIY. This is what it looks like. I am totally obsessed. Alright, so here is a DIY to spice up any boring white frame you have. So go ahead and take some masking tape and just kind of copy the pattern that I'm doing. You can totally do a different pattern, but I basically just did a lot of stripes, and I did them in kind of diagonal little lines, and then the center one I made
straight, and then the ones on the sides are diagonal again. If you guys can see what I'm talking about, it's kind of hard to explain, so just kind of watch. So after I was done, this is what it looked like, and you guys can also screenshot that as well just to see how I did it, because it's kind of hard to explain. So that's what it looks like with just the tape. Now I took a gold Sharpie, which I got from Michaels as well, and I filled in between all the masking tape with the gold Sharpie. Now I do have to admit that this gold Sharpie ended up looking a little bit green, which I was a little disappointed about, but it was the best I could find. And I also tried Sharpie gold ones and it didn't work, but oh well. So go ahead and take off the masking tape and you will have these clean straight lines. And that's what it will look like when you're done. I think it's super cute, it really spices up any image, and it looks great in your room. Okay, so for this one you're gonna need Mod Podge, brushes, a box, and magazines. I got all the supplies from Michaels and the magazines from CVS. Go ahead and go through your magazines and cut out things that you like. And then start kind of laying them out on your box to just kind of see how you would want them to look. And I picked out lots of summery images, as you guys can tell. Now I'm going ahead and gluing them down. So first put the Mod Podge on the box where your image is going to go. And then go ahead and lay your image down on that. And then you will put another layer of Mod Podge on top of it. Just make sure that you put Mod Podge on top of everything to make it stay in place and give it a nice glossy feel to it. And then for mine, I made the title and label Summer 2015. And then I went ahead and added some gold polka dots on my label. Here is what it looked like after I was done with all my cutouts and everything, and I really like it. Now what you're going to do is just go ahead and stick any pictures or things related to your summer that you want to remember. Letters, movies, pictures. You can even write down things you don't want to forget that happened. So for example, I wrote this down. So I hope you guys tried this out and this allows you to not forget awesome moments you had this summer. Okay guys, so this is a simple way to spice up your light switch, and I got an extra one from a hardware store, and I just began to draw some gold polka dots on it with that same gold Sharpie. So here is what mine looked like after I added all the gold polka dots on it. So I unscrewed my other light switch, and just make sure you're careful when you do this, especially if you have never done this before. And I went ahead and got my other one and just screwed that in, and that is it. It is so simple, and I really like this because it's a great way to easily spice up your room.
Calendar is still stuck on May, so we're switching to June right now. Here we go. Ta-da! So that was my summer DIY room decor video, and I really, really hope you guys liked it and hope you found these to be cute, original, and something that you want to try out yourself. And once again, if you do recreate these, please send me pictures. I would love to see how you guys style them or how you decorate it, and you can send those all to my social media, which is Janine Amapola for Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and Facebook. Once again, don't forget to check out Tana's video and leave a comment in her comments letting her know that I sent you. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let's try and get this to 5,000 likes, or let's try 7,000 likes. Let's try 7,000 likes. Why not? Let's do it. And thanks to Jacob over here for cutting tape for me.
Hi.
So yeah, I love you guys and I'll see you in my next video. Peace out, Girl Scout.